Hey, how you doing?
All right. Good to see you again, Herbert. This is Renee.
Hello, everyone.
This is Cliff.
Hey, everybody.
And this is Matt.
Hi.
Good to have you here.
So, Herbert, we just came down from the panhandle of North Florida where we were called by the Bridges family. They called us in because they were feeling threatened, uneasy. They had Sasquatch on their property. So we thought we'd come down here to the Seminoles in South Florida, since you've lived with them for thousands of years, that maybe you could give us some advice to bring back to them.
Tell them not to look at them as pests or animals. Look at them as human beings. The only way you can really coexist is to give them respect.
That's very good advice.
Have you ever actually seen one yourself?
Yes, I have. We were going into the swamps and cut logs out in order to build chickies and such. As we were walking this path, there was a palmetto tree standing there. And just then, something grabbed that palmetto leaves down, and then boom. Had to be like at least about 8 feet tall.
And that happened somewhere in this area?
Yeah. Back in the swamps here. Some of my cousins have seen it, but you have to get a hold of them in order to understand what their sightings were.
It was an honor coming here to meet you all and hearing about something I know that isn't talked about a lot. You gave us insights that we wouldn't hear anywhere else. It was really a great privilege.
Thank you for welcoming us.
Very good.
Herbert shared that the Seminole view Sasquatches as another people, much like themselves, and they treat them as another people. I think that one of the things that the Bridges can take away from what Herbert advised is to leave them alone, because the Sasquatches aren't living on the Bridges' land. The Bridges are living on the Sasquatches' land.
After listening to some stunning eyewitness reports at the meeting, we mapped out the exact locations where each of the incidents took place. We were particularly interested in the spots where the tribal elder claimed to have seen a skunk ape behind a palm tree, and where his cousin Billy may have encountered a skunk ape while walking through the woods. And finally, where Ron had seen a massive beast disappear into the forest. This narrows down our search area, so we can track down exactly where the skunk apes are hiding out.
During the course of our conversation with Herbert, he related to us that he has other family members that have had sightings and encounters. One that stood out was his cousin, Billy. We decided Matt and I were gonna go interview Billy, and Cliff and Renee will follow up with Herbert and go where he saw his Sasquatch.
Just like every location down here that the natives would go hunt at, this location where Billy is at is in a remote area. You can't easily drive up to it. We need to get on a swamp buggy to go out and meet him at this place where he's gonna be hunting.
Hey there, Billy.
Hello, how y'all doing?
All righty, thanks for meeting us.
So I hear that y'all look for somebody that seen Bigfoot?
Yeah.
Yep. Well, I'm the man. This is the place where I seen him. Yep, it was right out here. It was in the middle of this rainy season. I was walking out there, and there's a cypress tree that was over, and I walked over it. I looked to the right, about 35 yards from me. When I walked up and I looked, it went like this.
Wow.
And it looked at me. My hair stood up on my neck. I was in shock. I'm shaking right now, just thinking about it. I could feel them staring me down.
Did you see the legs and the feet?
Yeah, I seen the legs. I seen them about like that. He was real long, but I remember him doing something with his feet.
I'd like to get the same distance you were from when you saw it, then I'll kind of try to recreate it, and you tell me how big it looked compared to me. Would you want to do that?
Okay, all right, sure. Let's
follow
check it
you.
Out. Stay right in here.
This is the sort of place where if there's a little bit of water, there's probably alligators and water moccasins.
You always walk barefoot, Billy?
Yeah, all the time. Never wear shoes.
Well, how about I'll walk down that way, and you tell me about when it's about the same distance and tell me to stop when you think that's how far it was.
Okay.
And Bobo, as he usually does, he volunteered to go over and be where the Sasquatch was, and I took the witness to the point of his perspective. We got about the same distance, and we got kind of a sense of what he would have seen.
right to your right. That tree right there beside you, right there.
Right there.
Right here?
That's about where he was. He was a little bit taller than that.
About this tall, maybe?
A little bit more. Yeah, about right in there.
So that's over a foot taller than me. That would put that thing well over 7 foot, close to 7.5 feet.
Wow.
I got at least a foot above my head before he said that's how tall it was. So you're talking something that's so enormous. It'd weigh at least twice as much as me. You're getting something in the upwards of over 600 pounds.
So you're saying it was doing something with its feet, like down below it, like it was moving something around. Would you be able to kick up swamp apples like
that? Yeah, I'm pretty sure, because when they're not ripe, they sink.
Have you ever seen a swamp apple, Bobo?
I've seen them, but I've never eaten one.
Florida skunk apes are known to eat a variety of different foods, not just deer and wild hogs, but also snakes and frogs and alligators and birds, even swamp apples. That's how they've been able to survive in such an unforgiving environment.
Then what I seen, about 35 yards.
My sense is that Billy actually saw one. There was some just kind of unusual sort of arbitrary factors to it.
And I could see his shoulder and his face looking at me.
It wouldn't be the sort of garden variety generic sighting that somebody would make up.
My hair stood up on my neck.
It really struck me as being a legitimate incident.
It went like this.
Cliff and I went out and met with Herbert at the exact location where his encounter occurred.
We was walking down this path here, and it was right about here when I saw it. Right there was the creature where it was standing. And it sounded like he just reached up and grabbed and slapped the leaves down. And it just turned and ran.
You know, that's exactly a classic ape territorial display there, making a big noise. Kind of almost just like to startle you before it escapes.
Silverback lowland gorilla.
They do that.
Boom!
Yeah.
Maybe I'll pop in there.
Sure.
Yeah,
go make some noise.
Yeah.
Try to scare us, Renee.
I'll try, guys. I'm not that big. I'm no Bobo, that's for sure.
Move forward a little bit toward the trees. Okay, right about there. Yeah, that's exactly where it was.
Okay, so first you hear a crash?
Yeah, like the palmetto leaves got slapped really hard.
Okay, get ready, Herbert.
All right. All the branches. You're not capable of making that type of noise.
So after it moved the palmetto leaves, you said it headed in this direction?
Yes, he took off right to where the trees and the bushes are.
Okay.
Renee tried to duplicate the running off into the brush to see if she can do it in a similar manner.
Here we go.
Two of her stripes is probably one of his. There's no way she can run as fast as that thing moved.
Okay, longer strides. What about the arm swing? Was it the same or
different? It was slower. To me, he just looked like he just and he was gone. And before, there was logs laying on the ground, too.
So it was hurtling the logs?
It was hurtling the logs.
Okay.
And then that would have been a big difference.
So, yeah.
But I'm not sure of the stripes, because it moved very gracefully. So it just looked like it was just floating.
That's an interesting parallel to what a lot of other people report when they see them run or walk, is that they say that they're almost gliding over the ground, almost not even touching it.
Yeah, because they're very strong in their magic or medicine. Mm-hmm. So as they run, they run on the medicine plants that you discover all through the path here. And that's what they step on. So they step on medicine. They're never making any noise. They're just like just gliding across the top of the ground without never touching the ground.
Interesting.
Are you positive what you saw? Is there any chance it could have been anything else?
No, because I've lived out here in the Florida swamps all my life, and I've seen just about everything. And what I saw that day was humanoid looking.